Hello, SCHS, and welcome to Season 3 of SCTV News. I'm Kyler Elliott.
And I'm Darissa Ochoa. With the start of a new season here at SCTV, it's time to meet the new crew.
We sure have a great team here, and we look forward to bringing all the news at SCHS.
Along with the new group here at SCTV, Smith Center High School has a few new faces amongst the staff. We now go to Kenya to introduce them.
This year, we have welcomed 4 new teachers to the Smith Center Junior Senior High School. Starting off, we welcome Mrs. Robin Kelsch, wife of Principal Mr. Kelsch. She will be teaching business and computer classes. Next, we welcome Mr. Sage Slaffley. He will be teaching medical and science classes. Also teaching science classes is Mrs. Jessica Lehman. Finally, we welcome Avery Hawkins. He has been part of the SCHS family, coaching football and wrestling. Now he is teaching special education for junior high. For SC News, I'm Kenya Grazzi.
Thank you, Kenya. Not only do we have new faces here, but all the high school students are carrying their sleek new Chromebooks. Reporter Nevaeh Rohan has more on the story.
The Smith Center 9th through 12th students were given personal Chromebooks to keep and use at school and at home throughout the school year. We're here with Mr. Kelsch to get the inside scoop on everything you need to know about these new Chromebooks.
The district purchased Chromebooks. We purchase X amount of Chromebooks every year to try to replace. The goal is to replace those that age out and can't be updated anymore. The district office is generous enough to be able to provide funds for us to be able to do that. Well, it gives them the opportunity to be able to do their work at home. Helps them to, most kids have computers at home or Chromebooks at home, but those that do not, especially with families that have multiple kids, multiple students in one house, they're able to have their own computer and hopefully get their work done.
Now that we know more about them, we hit the hallways to ask students how having Chromebooks accessible to them at all times has been beneficial for them. Who am I here with?
Breely Martin.
And how has having a Chromebook at home helped you be more productive during the school year?
I can do all my homework in the middle of the night. Okay, I don't have to worry about just getting it on my phone.
Who am I here with?
Tyler Quinn.
And how has Chromebooks helped you be more productive at home this school year?
So when you take a nap and you realize you have an assignment due at like 12 and you're like, oh shoot, I gotta get this done. Typey, type, 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 turned in, A+.
Very nice. Who am I here with?
Philip Levan.
And does having a Chromebook at home help you be more productive during the school year?
Certainly.
Who am I here with?
Gavin Hickett.
And Gavin, how does it feel to have a Chromebook at home, aside from just having it at school?
Very helpful.
I know it has been most helpful having my own device, Before heading back to school, many of our students have had quite a busy summer. Our SCTV news reporters caught up with all the happenings.
Smith Center High School students ventured across the United States to visit our nation's capital, Washington, D.C., from July 24th through July 27th. Students flew to Ronald Reagan Washington Airport to begin their first day of the trip. Across the span of 3 days, students visited three states and locations such as Mount Vernon, the White House, Gettysburg, Arlington Cemetery, and many more. We asked history teacher Alex Hubbleman about his Washington, D.C. experience.
This summer, a group of Smith Center students, along with a group of Thunder Ridge students, were able to take a trip to Washington, D.C. A couple things, I had to write them down, otherwise I'd forget. But we spent 4 days in D.C. We were able to see the Smithsonian Museums, Mount Vernon, the Holocaust Museum, Gettysburg, and the Arlington National Cemetery. I would say for the most part it was a fun trip. There were some challenges with a big group of students, but for the most part it was a lot of fun. My favorite part was Mount Vernon. I don't know about you guys, but I liked it. And it was such a successful trip that we're going to do it again in the summer of 2026. So.
I'm Kenya Gotze here with Avery Hawkins, the summer weights coach. Avery, what are your expectations for students in the weight room?
Number one thing is show up. Okay, attendance is really important. If you're here, then you can do things. But if you don't get in the door, we can't get anything done. So other than that, we need to stay safe. We teach lifting to the young kids in junior high just so they can stay safe and not get injured in here. A lot of people think that lifting is to get stronger, which it is, but the primary thing it's for is to prevent injuries. So if we're stronger, the less likely we are to get injured. So that's why we do what we do.
Can you tell us a little bit about the power poster?
Yeah, the power poster is something that we used to do here for a long time, and we've recently brought that back here the last couple of years. It's basically a club for those kids in the high school, both male and female, that are very strong. So you can have a power ratio of 3.5 as a female or 5.0 as a male to reach the power poster. And basically that means you can lift 3.5 or 5 times your body weight within the three main lifts that we do, which is squat, bench, and clean. Other than that, there's some benchmarks that you can hit for each lift. So on squat, if you hit a certain number of pounds, then you can get on the power poster and so on and so forth. But the reason we do it is just to see progress and give people their flowers when they do good things. And we would like everybody to get on there, but we've grown it the last 2 years. Last year we have 8 more people on it this year than we did last year, so that's a big improvement.
Wow. Okay, well, thank you, Avery.
Hello, I'm here with Madison Howland, who competed at National Track this summer. Maddie, what was the meet?
USATF National Junior Olympic Track and Field at College Station, Texas.
What events did you do?
I did the 3,000, the 1,500, and the 4x8 relay.
How did you do on each of those?
In the 3,000 and the 1,500, I got first, and my 4x8 team got third.
What was your favorite event?
My favorite event was probably the 3,000.
The week before school, several seniors were spotted using their artistic skills to mark their spot for the year's parking. This was the third year seniors have painted parking spots. Stucco has organized the event. For SCTV, I'm Duriso Ochoa.
I found myself in the weight room most of the summer.
I was busy with work. A lot of fun, wasn't it?
Sure was. A new start to the school year means a new year for our clubs. Easton is here to give us a summer recap for FFA and FCCLA.
I'm Easton Raby, and I'm here with
Carson Sass
and Ruby Gomolostoff.
So FCCLA had a pretty eventful summer. What conferences and activities did you guys participate in over the summer?
Over the summer, I went to Seattle, Washington, and participated in the National Leadership Conference and competed in star events. I placed 7th in the nation with my star event.
So just here in August, we had our Take AIM conference, which is put on by the peer education team for the state, which I'm a part of. We had a pretty good conference. We were able to put on some workshops and some leadership development things for students.
Which one was most impactful to you guys?
I would say a National Leadership Conference because I was able to see a really big city like Seattle and just see what Seattle has to offer.
I would have to say your Take Aim Conference just because I was able to grow as a leader and meet a lot of new people and hopefully have an impact on some members through our workshops.
How about which one was your guys' favorite?
National Leadership Conference because Seattle is a pretty cool city. We got to go to a baseball game and I was able to go to the Space Needle.
I would also have to say our Nationals Conference. It was a lot of fun and I got to see a lot of cool things.
So what activities are coming up for FCCLA?
We're both district officers for District B and we have our Fall Leadership Conference coming up in Ellis, so that would be pretty fun to go to.
Not only am I a district officer, but I'm a part of peer education, so I get to help put on the conference, and then I also get to do a workshop as a peer education member, so I get to educate members on traffic safety.
How do you both feel about this upcoming year?
Now, I'm really excited because this is my second term as a district officer, and the second year in a row I've got to be able to serve with a person from my school, so it'll be pretty fun.
I'm also really excited about this year. I feel like we have a lot of good leadership potential, and then we have a lot of fun activities we can do.
It's definitely going to be a good one. Thank you. Hi, I'm Easton Raby, and I'm here with
Mrs. Wagner,
Ruby Gomolostoff.
What conferences and activities did FFA participate over the summer?
The first one we attended was State Convention right after school got out. And
I also attended District Officer Conference because I'm this year's District Vice President. And then we also had our officer retreat to Colorado Springs.
So what activity was your favorite?
My favorite was probably the officer retreat because I got to know my officers really well and we had lots of fun.
Mine was also the officer retreat. I really got to know my team and make some fun memories.
What activity was most impactful to you?
I'd have to say the state convention just because we had six members who got their state degree and that's quite an achievement. So I was super proud of my students.
I would have to say district officer conference for me just because I really got to know my district officer team and I got to meet a lot of the other district officers from around the state and learn leadership skills from the state officers.
How do you both feel about this upcoming year?
I think we're going to have a great year. We have some great leaders and lots of membership, so I'm looking forward to a great year.
I'm really excited about this year and we already had our land judging competition and our 8th grade team did very well, so I'm really excited to see how they do this year as well.
Alrighty, thank you.
Seems like a lot of SCHS students were busy helping out our community.
Speaking of busy, our Redmen and Lady Red athletes are busy kicking off the 2024 fall season. Let's go to the sports report.
Hello, Redmen and Lady Red fans. I'm Easton, along with Nevaeh, for your SCTV Sports News Report.
The 2024 fall season sports started off with the Redcaps kickoff on August 30th. The volleyball and football teams each held a scrimmage followed by a pep rally at Hubbard Stadium. Redcaps president Adam Renschler shared about what Redcaps does to help our student athletes.
Redcaps is a booster organization that is solely funded by the parents that are our members. We charge $35 a year. We do accept business memberships, and what we do is we provide the tailgate for tonight. Just a simple hot dog, chips, cookie, drink. We ask everyone bring a package of multi-pack of Gatorade or a sports drink that we can divvy out amongst the athletic teams. The biggest thing we do is provide scholarships. For instance, last year we gave $3,200 away to 8 kids in scholarships. The only requirement we ask is, number one, you've got to graduate. Number two, your parents have to be part of Redcaps for 4 years prior to the application process. We do sponsorship of the power poster that Coach Rogers does. We provide financial support for any team that decides to have a banquet at the end of their season. The green calendars everyone's used to seeing for years, we pay for those.
We'd like to thank the Redcaps boosters for all their support of our athletic teams. The cross country team has started their season with meets at TMP, Webster Lake, and our home meet. Sophomore Maddie Howland has picked up where she left off last season, dominating on all three races. Junior Gavin Hickert broke the school record at the Smith Center meet. Coach Kelly Armconnect has a lot to look forward to with this year's team.
I'm feeling good about it. I have some great runners and I'm excited. They have been running extra hard in practice and have been working hard. We've got some cooler practices in where they got a lot of miles in, and now we're training in the heat. I am looking forward to seeing people get their personal best and make improvements and hopefully bring lots of medals home.
Congratulations on that accomplishment and keep up the great work, cross country team. The Lady Red volleyball team are rebuilding after losing 5 key starters from last year's team. New head coach Denise Kattenberg gives her thoughts for the upcoming season.
Hello, SC News. I'm Kenya Gotzi, and today I will be talking to head coach Denise Kattenberg, as she has been the assistant coach in past years.
How has the team been preparing for the upcoming season?
Well, we started in June with weightlifting every day, Monday through Friday. Then we did summer league, and then we went to the Abilene Spectacular, and then we just started with conditioning. And the kids have just been in the gym working hard on our fundamentals every day, and like we are have had the last 2 days have been the best practices of the season, so we're getting better for sure.
What are you most excited for this upcoming season?
I think what we're most excited for is just the how all the summer workouts and all the beginning of the season workouts pays off in the end of the season, how much better we're going to get. I'm excited to see our leadership grow. I'm excited to see young players become, just better players throughout experience. I can't wait to watch all of that just come together.
For SC News, I'm Kenya Grazzi.
The Redmond football team has started their season traveling to Chapman before facing their league rivals, Phillipsburg and Norton. Head coach Mike Rogers gives his insight on this season.
We're optimistic. We feel like we put in a lot of hard work over the summer, and we feel like we have enough talent to have a good season, so we're optimistic and ready to get it started. Well, like I said, I think we had a great summer in the weight room, and we started doing some other things on the field, which I think really has helped us come along. So, I think it has a good work ethic. You know, I think we need to be a little bit more consistent, but I'm really happy with the work that they have put in. You know, every year is an adventure. There's nothing wrote in stone. And so, you know, it's to see how the season unfolds and what we're able to do and what we're able to accomplish. So,
keep working hard, Redmond and Lady Red. For your SC News Sports Report, I'm Nevaeh.
And I'm Easton. Back to you, Darissa and Kyler.
Way to go, Redmond and Lady Red, on getting started on your seasons.
Darissa, how long does it take you to pick out an outfit?
At least 30 minutes.
I just take the first shirt on the pile. It's really easy to do.
Picking the perfect outfit for school pictures can take a lot of time. We went to our reporter Tegan to see what SC students wore for this special occasion.
Hello, SCTV. I'm Tegan Maxwell. Today, I interviewed our students to see what outfits they chose for picture day. Avery, today is picture day. Why did you choose this outfit?
I chose this outfit because I think it looks nice, looks professional.
All right, outfit of the day. Where did you get everything?
I got this polo from USD 237. I got these pants from Amazon, I think, and these are a good old TikTok shop shoe.
All right. Reed, today is picture day. Why did you choose this outfit?
So I could support the Lady Red basketball team.
All right. OOTD, where did you get everything from?
I got this from Kaylin's dresser. I got these shorts from adidas.com. The socks from Nike.com and the shoes from Nike.com.
Perfect, thank you. Mr. Wick, today is picture day. Why did you choose this outfit?
I was really, really worried. I just wanted to make sure I didn't have the same thing on last year.
All right, OOTD, where did you get everything from?
Kohl's. Kohl's America.
All right. Keely, today is picture day. Why did you choose this outfit?
I looked fly in it.
All right, OOTD, where did you get everything from?
Marshall's, my sister's closet, Hey Dudes.
Yep.
Okay. Elle, today is picture day. Why did you choose this outfit?
Because I love this tank top and these jeans are my favorite.
Okay, OOTD, where'd you get everything?
All right, so this top is from Maurice's. These are 7 jeans. These are Ariat shoes or Twisted X's shoes. Nails are done by Sammy at the Looking Glass. And the ring is from Riddles.
Perfect.
Yep.
Esther, today is picture day. Why did you choose this outfit?
Because it's fun.
All right. And OOTD, where did you get it all from?
This is from Claire's. This is from Bloom's on Main Street. This is from Old Navy. And these are from Torrid Online.
For SCTV, I'm Tegan Maxwell.
It's a lot of pressure to have the perfect outfit for picture day.
Speaking of pressure, have you ever talked to someone who mumbled and you didn't know what they were saying, but you tried to act like you heard them?
No, But some of our students are going to experience that. We go to Easton to put students in this awkward situation.
Hi, my name is Easton Raby, and I'm here with...
Freely Martin.
Okay, so we're just going to ask you a few questions about school starting. So, how do you feel about school starting when all the race and new stuff?
What?
Alrighty, that's all the time we have for today. Alrighty, who am I here with?
Corey Waltmer.
So, Corey, how do you feel about school starting with all the new teachers and then doing all the writing stuff?
I feel good. The new teachers have been nice, and they've been teaching me a lot of stuff.
What about, like, your grades and students and stuff?
My grades are good. All A's right now.
Do what about the organizations and stuff?
I'm an FFA officer, and we're doing a lot more stuff in there, so you should join FFA.
Alrighty. So what about the directors and stuff? We're good. Hi, I'm here with...
L. Jacobs.
Alrighty. So how do you feel about school starting with all the new teachers and they're getting all the rain stuff?
What? Hold on. What did you say? I can't hear you.
Okay, so what did you... How do you feel about school starting with all the new teachers and all the grading stuff?
I feel like it's going to be a great year. I honestly am a little nervous. Don't know what to expect for the rest of the year, but I'm excited. Senior year.
Alrighty, thank you. Alrighty, who am I here with?
Sage Slaffley.
So, how do you feel about school starting with all the new teachers and all the students and stuff?
I'm excited. I actually kind of wish school started a little earlier because there's so much time between summer. I actually look forward to school starting. With all the new teachers I've met, I feel like most of them for the most part, but it's hard with all the classes. I don't have a ton of interaction.
What about the weather and the chatters and stuff?
The what? The weather? Wait. What did you say? The weather and the tri-part?
Alrighty, who am I here with?
Mrs. Eflin.
Alrighty, so how do you feel about school starting and all the teachers and the students and stuff?
Say that one time.
How do you feel about school starting with all the new teachers and students and stuff?
Oh, I think it's great to have the new teachers. I wish we would just have more time to get to know them before the school year starts.
What about all the students and and stuff?
Huh? What'd you say?
I said that's all the time we have for today. Thanks for watching, and remember, it's not news unless it's SC news.
Okay, cut it.
Shimmy, 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 yeah, shimmy, yeah.
Who am I here with?
Tyler Quinn.
For on the day. Wrong?
Yes! Messed up.
Having a Chromebook accessible at school and at home has made you more productive so far in the school year.
That is not the same.
Okay, remind you.
God dang it! I swear!